class, and we hope that you'll enjoy the performance. A couple of notes about our Performing Arts Center. The Jennifer L. Dorsey Holley Performing Arts Center is named for Jennifer L. Dorsey Holley, who died in attacks of 9/11. We take a great deal of pride in our facility, in her memory. So a couple of things we want to make sure you're aware of. Make sure you leave your backpacks in the classroom. The teachers probably mentioned that. No food or drink in the theater. Make sure you keep your feet on the floor. Please don't put them up on the seats in front of you. Please don't climb over the seats or do anything that might damage those seats. Make sure to remove your hats in our facility. Make sure you turn off your electric device. Okay, make sure it's on silent. Please don't talk or text during the performance. Don't put your headphones on and listen to other music during the performance. It's really rude to our musicians and our guests from Lincoln High. And we're not all from Lincoln High, I'll let them talk about that. Anyway, I'll let you know to talk about that for a minute. Please don't go in and out during the performance. If you do need to leave, make sure it's between the musical selections if something comes up, if you have an emergency. Please don't leave until we turn the house lights up. Cameras and recording devices are strictly prohibited and will be confiscated. This is Mr. Noser, who is the chairperson for the music department at Lincoln High and in charge of this particular group. So let's give him a Southeast welcome.
My name is Brett Noser. I'm the director of Los Mariachis de la Ciudad de Estrella. Along with Dr. McCullough back on trumpet, we would like to introduce Los Mariachis. And the first song that we're going to be singing for you and playing for you is called Los Aguacates, which is the avocados.
Yeah. digo, paso ti, paso ti, paso ti. Mis padres que me toquen suavecito, el son de los aguacates.
Toquen suavecito,
el son de los aguacates. Este horadita les digo a todititos mis padres.
Last week, Dr. McCullough talked to us because she's actually been in some professional mariachis. She'll talk a little bit more about that later. But some mariachis will have just one stylized tie. Sometimes they might have multiple. It depends on what they're doing, what kind of event they're doing, quinceañeras, weddings, birthdays, funerals, things like that. They might change it just a little bit. The ones that we have are actually stylized specifically for us, and we kind of agreed on what the colors we wanted to use, because around Nebraska, we really like red and black. So we decided on those two for sure. And then we kind of threw another idea in there to throw in goldenrod, because that's the state flower. Okay, so it kind of, as one of our students put it, it kind of sets off the beauty of the whole thing. So those are our three colors. And on the moño itself, it has a picture of the capital with a star, because it's the capital city of Star City. All right, the next piece that we're going to be playing for you is Como Quien Pierde Una Estrella. And normally this is a song, but today we're going to be playing it just as instrumental. Thank you.
Thank you.
late 1800s when mariachi started. And actually, at that time, mariachi was a little bit different than it does now. The original, like what we have in history written down, is that one of the first mariachis went to the capital in Mexico at the time, and they had a harp player, a guitar player, and two violinists. And they went to play for the president at the time. Where they came from was a state that was on the, would be the, like the west or the southwest coast of Mexico. So that's where mariachi originated from, and it's been a very nationalistic style of music. So whenever you hear it, you think of the country of Mexico. Okay, so the next piece we're going to be playing for you is actually based off of a Mexican folk tale called La Llorona. Sounds of cheers or things like that. And actually, we call these gritos. And you might hear some of our performers doing this at some point. It's when they hear something that they really, really enjoy, they might throw some gritos at the performers up on stage. So if there's something that you hear that you like, si señor or si señorita, for example, when Cindy was singing, they might sing, they might yell to her because they're absolutely loving what she's doing, or they love what the trumpet is playing, or something along those lines. Okay? So the next one, this next piece is called Árboles de la Barranca, and this one is a piece for the entire mariachi to be singing and playing at the same time.
Fake gut strings on there. Instead of the steel string, don't play steel string. And then you have our abuela, which is like a guitar, but it has five strings. It's missing the low E string. It also plays, basically, it plays the same chords, it just looks different because we're missing the E string. Then you have our guitarrón, which plays our bass part. The cool thing about that is you can play, it always plays two notes at the same time, in octave.
Thank you.
we have two more songs for you this morning. This first one that we're going to do right now is called De Colores. Again, this is with the entire mariachi singing and playing. Thank you very much.